Stop Planned Parenthood is through prayer, through sacrifice, and through public witness to the evil that is going on within the walls of those buildings. As somebody who's been involved in the pro-life movement for almost 40 years, I can never forget the first person who ever said to me that the rosary is the only weapon that will ever shut down Planned Parenthood and will ever stop abortion, and that person was Professor Charles Rice. He said it then, nobody paid attention to him. We're saying it again now, and people are going to pay attention to him, to us, and we are going to stop Planned Parenthood.
25 years ago yesterday, STOP held its first public protest against Planned Parenthood as we picketed a clinic that they operated in Poughkeepsie, New York. Since that time, we have conducted thousands of protests at Planned Parenthood clinics all across the country. I have to say that it's great to see all of you out here today. There is one person in particular who was with us there in Poughkeepsie 25 years ago, and of course I'm talking about my wife, Michaeline, who has been in this fight since the very beginning. We fight Planned Parenthood because they are the root of abortion in this country. They are the people who brought abortion to the United States systematically and with a plan. Planned Parenthood is today the largest abortion chain in the nation. According to their own numbers, they do over 300,000 abortions a year in their own facilities. This is an organization that makes its living on killing babies. A little while ago, a woman named Abby Johnson in Bryan College Station, Texas, quit her job as the clinic director of Planned Parenthood and joined the pro-life side. And what she revealed when she quit her job was that Planned Parenthood pushes abortion, that it is their biggest moneymaker, that it is what brings in the income that allows Planned Parenthood to operate in economically bad times. And so you can bet that today, across the street, there are women who are being pressured into having an abortion just so Planned Parenthood has more money to put in the bank on Monday. This is pure evil. Over the years in fighting Planned Parenthood, we have seen a number of successes. Planned Parenthood back in 1995 had 938 clinics across the nation. Today they have 797. That's over 141 communities that don't have Planned Parenthood in them anymore. Those 141 communities had people just like the folks here who rose up against Planned Parenthood, who said no more to the killing of babies, who said no more to leading our teenagers into lives of sexual sin, who said no more to Planned Parenthood, and Planned Parenthood is now out of their communities. But we face a big challenge here in 2010, because Planned Parenthood still has those 797 clinics, and we are going to target and we are going to close them down. But now they've got an even greater ally in the federal government. With the passage of health care reform, there are going to be millions upon millions of dollars that are going to pour into Planned Parenthood's coffers. And somehow we have to find a way to overcome the money. Well, for many years, we've been traveling around the country and we've been talking to people about the amount of government money that Planned Parenthood gets. One third of their income now is taxpayer dollars. And it will even be more in the future. And they have millions upon millions of dollars. But I always say Planned Parenthood has the money and we have God. And I think we have an unfair advantage because God will close down Planned Parenthood. And in facing this issue of closing Planned Parenthood this year, in praying about what we do now that the health care reform bill has passed, the answer came, we turned to Mary, the mother of God. Mary has the ability to close down Planned Parenthood. And so we've rededicated our efforts to Mary, the mother of God. We've rededicated our efforts to bringing Jesus to Planned Parenthood through Mary. Because after all, that's how God brought Jesus to us. He could have sent Jesus any way he wanted, but he sent Jesus to us through Mary. And that's how we're bringing him to Planned Parenthood, through the Blessed Mother. And so what we want to do this morning is to formally dedicate our efforts to Mary.
I have to tell you, Bishop Yonta was very, very devoted to our Blessed Mother. And one of the first things he did when he got to Amarillo and found out we had all those Planned Parenthood facilities was he dedicated our diocese to Our Lady of Guadalupe under her title as Patroness of the Unborn. He also helped us get a great big picture of Our Lady, and we carried it to every Planned Parenthood event that we attended, and they were legion. Our motto became, wherever Planned Parenthood is, there we shall be also. And with us, we always had a big image of Our Lady of Guadalupe, and we were praying the rosary everywhere we went. Planned Parenthood CEO said, we just want them to go away. Why won't they go away? And I assured her that we would go away as soon as they closed up the doors of the last clinic. So that is our promise to Planned Parenthood. God has worked mighty miracles through his mother, Our Lady of Guadalupe, to close down all those Planned Parenthood facilities in the Texas Panhandle. And God will do that through Mary throughout this nation. We can take that to the bank if we just continue to persevere and pray. I want to share with you maybe just one quick story about a miracle that we saw in the Amarillo Diocese through Our Lady's intercession. And there are so many, it's hard for me to pick. But I'm thinking this morning of one particular story about a poor tortured woman who had had many abortions in her lifetime. She saw us praying the rosary in front of a Planned Parenthood facility in Amarillo. And she had gone to Catholic school, so she identified with the rosary, she identified with the picture of Our Lady of Guadalupe, so she pulled her car over and came and knelt with us and prayed one decade of the rosary, and she was obviously very shaken. So she got up and left, and I followed to see if there was any way I could help her. We talked for a long time, and she was not Catholic, but she had this Catholic culture in her that she picked up at Catholic school. And so when she saw us praying the rosary, by the way, she was on her way to buy dog food that morning. It was the rosary that drew her to Planned Parenthood that morning. And ultimately, as we prayed, that brought her to God's forgiveness because she thought that she had committed sins that could never be forgiven. And she was just devastated. And her life had been so horribly impacted by those abortions. But we prayed, she found God's forgiveness, and as she found that forgiveness, you could just see the hurt and the torture falling off of her, and she began to glow. And she said to me, Rita, you know, I feel like I've been hanging on the cross for 25 years, and now I can finally come down. That's how Our Lady works. She brought her poor, hurting daughter to Planned Parenthood that morning for forgiveness. And we've seen Our Lady close Planned Parenthood facilities specifically, we know, because of the rosaries that were prayed there. We've seen abortion workers leave Planned Parenthood. One lady left Planned Parenthood, went to another facility. She said it was because Our Blessed Mother was showing up there at Planned Parenthood, and she couldn't stand that image of Our Blessed Mother looking at her while she was working. So she transferred to another facility. Lo and behold, the Blessed Mother showed up there too. And she couldn't take it, so she quit after some 25 years of employment with Planned Parenthood. Our Blessed Mother will close down all these Planned Parenthood facilities in the country. We are sure of that. We just ask you to persevere in prayer.